Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome back. Let's get things started, shall we? If you'd like to join the conversation, you can do so at 513-873-7134. Viva La Chapas. Good morning. It is a beautiful Tuesday in the city of Cincinnati. It's election day, not just in Cincinnati, but various states across the nation, including our friends in Kentucky. What's up, KY? What up? If you've never been to Cincinnati, then you don't know that. I mean, literally from downtown Cincinnati, there's parts of you can see Kentucky. It's that close, right over the Ohio River. Same river my ancestors crossed trying to get freedom. Did Harriet Tubman cross the Ohio River? It's a trivia question. We might get into some Harriet Tubman conversation, but today is election day. Election day. There's been so much time and energy and expense. I think if you totaled up all of the candidates, I think you're probably easily maybe like coming up close to $500,000. You got municipal court judges, and you got Cincinnati school board members. You got a levy. You got some big decisions. Issue 22. And if you want to talk about it, well, this is a place for intelligent black people in the greater Cincinnati area to come together and, well, chop it up. Hence the name, the Chop Shop. Plus, they will chop you up. I'm going to tell you, be warned. Be warned. But what's on your mind, really? I want to reflect back on some of the conversations that we have had with some of the various candidates. Man, we've had some very interesting conversations. Very interesting. I want to give you a few things to remember before you vote. And will Kentucky keep Matt Bevin? He's running against Beshear. Is it Beshear? Beshear, right? Matt Bevin, he seems like a kook to me, but I don't live in the KY, so I guess he's not really my problem. But I got no way it is my problem, because I have to go through KY to get to the airport, so it's my problem too. It's all of our problems. Any KY listeners out there like to know? Oh, okay. I see you there. I see you there, man. What's going to happen today? What is going to happen today? I want to know. And I want to talk about all the things away from that as well. There's a lot of things that have been going on that we just haven't get a chance to get to because we've been focusing on this upcoming election. Had some humdingers yesterday, boy. Including my new mans in them. Oh, dear Lord. Dear Lord, what's going to happen in all of these critical races? What is going to happen? Many of you have already voted. I see people on my Facebook page saying their support for various candidates. Quite interesting. And if you are a grown black person, person of color, working class person, and you're not voting, I would like to know why. I would like to know why. I see people are up and posting already. Yeah, I see. I see you. Get your post on. Hey, good morning. This is Cincinnati's longest running daily digital show. In fact, I don't know of any other daily digital shows that have been running in Cincinnati during the same time that we've been in this space. And we chop it up. You know, it's sort of like if you're into talk radio, if you like that, the exchange of human voices and ideas, the clash of ideas, you might get into the Nathan Ivey show. If you're born in a silver spoon in your mouth, you may not appreciate this show. You just might not get it. If you're all rigid in whatever your thing is, if you all like self-consciously rigid in who you are, you probably won't like this show because everything gets challenged. Everything and everybody gets challenged on the Nathan Ivey show, including the Nathan Ivey show. People challenge the very nature of the show. What is this? Okay, there's election night party. Maybe I'll go to the election night parties tonight. You know, I like to hang out with the winners. I'll be hanging out in the winner's circle tonight. I don't go to loser's party. Sorry. I'm not going to your party. You know, listen, I'm not saying you a loser because I don't look at it like that. I just won't be there. I'm hanging out with the winners tonight. Who will be the winners tonight? Critical decisions, man. School board decisions, critical. Critical. What's going to happen? We don't know. We'll find out together, my friends. Hold on. I don't trust you. I'll be honest with you. I trust you, the choppers. I don't trust everybody else, though. You know, I trust you, obviously. I just don't trust the rest of Cincinnati, the rest of mankind. I don't trust them. Low information voters. Too many low information voters, right? Ah, man. Let me see. Okay, we definitely want to discuss that. We'll be talking about the election as long as you want to talk about the election. In whatever facet, I'm going to go back into the archives and play some of the more interesting moments. And then tonight, I'll be hanging with the champions. And bad mistakes. I've made a few. That's Queen. All right, enough of that. Yeah, it's going to be a good time tonight. Somebody's going to be happy, right? Yeah, somebody's going to be singing this tonight. Something like that. I think that might be the feeling. Yeah, you may have some new school board members tonight. That'll be exciting. Kinda. Maybe not really. It might be an exercise that we don't want to do. I don't know. Make your own decisions. Oh, man. It's a good time of the year. It really is. I love this time of the year. It's raining, right? The leaves are turning. I'm seeing all different types of colors with the leaves. I mean, because green, I mean, come on. Change it up, nature. Boom. Fall. Love it. Cincinnatians love this kind of weather. If you don't love this kind of weather, something's wrong with you. It's nothing like the Cincinnati air after a good rain. Nothing like it. And if you don't have a beard, if you ain't rocking some kind of hair on your face, I'm questioning you. Something. And no, the hair in your nose does not count. Does not count. You must have some kind of facial hair. Sorry. Don't mean to offend anybody. It's a little early to be offended, folks. Good morning to you. Come on in. Many things to discuss today. So what are we doing with this election, yo? Let's put it on the table. What are we doing here? What are we doing here? Have you already voted? I'd like to know. Again, tonight somebody's going to be happy. And someone's not going to be happy. And that's just the way it goes. It's the way it goes. You either win or you lose. We'll find out what's going to happen today. Ashley writes, good morning, Nathan and the Choppers. Good morning to you, Ashley. Cassandra writes, hey, Choppers. Ray writes, grand risings all. Sharp writes, great risings on this wet election day. I love it. I love it when it's raining on election day. I love it. It adds something to it. It adds a little more texture and character to the whole day. None of this nonsense about, oh, it's going to keep people, the rain going to keep people in. Those people were never going to vote anyway. If the rain keeps you in from voting, they were never going to vote anyway. I don't believe that. I don't believe there's somebody that's dead set. They've been waiting for election. They look outside like, damn, I can't go now. Can't go. Who's doing that? Nobody. Nobody. Like, damn, I was going to go. Had my heart set on it. Knew what I was going to vote for and everything. You look outside like, damn, it's raining. Oh, shit. Can't go now. Yeah, that doesn't happen. Never happens in my lifetime. Never happened in my lifetime. Sharp writes, great risings on this wet election. I read that. Keith writes, vainglorious morning, Choppers. Are you hitting us with the vainglorious? Okay, vainglorious morning. I love it. I don't say that enough, vainglorious. Brenda writes, happy Tuesday. Mazone writes, good morning. Angela writes, salutations. Who's on your ballot? Great question. CJ writes, good morning, all. Tracy writes, hey, Mazone writes, I just voted in my polling place, and damn, those poll workers move so slow. I hope they're not working next year in the presidential election, all I'm saying. Damn. Moving slow, huh? It's not good. Fame writes, good morning. If you see me working a poll today, mind your business. Hashtag Westside. Okay. Let us know where you are. I'm going to come over and visit you, man. I'm going to come visit you this morning. Pamela writes, good morning, A and the Choppers. Good morning to you, Pamela. Muzon writes, that is one race I'm definitely keeping my eyes on. That Bevin's and Bashir race. Yeah. Yeah, Bevin's is, man. You know who loves, you know, Bevin's boy is running for a school board. Your boy Meggerly, that's one of Bevin's big bitch supporters right there on the low low. Or maybe probably not so low low. If I had asked him, he said, oh yeah, I love Bevin. He would double, triple down on. I love Bevin. Love Matt Bevin. I don't think Matt Bevin is good for the good people of Kentucky at all. I don't know why the hell y'all elected this fool, but you did, so. Got to deal with them now. Tanika writes, good morning, Nate and the Choppers. Angela writes, going to be some disappointed people today. Some disappointed folks today. I know that's right. And there's also some people who are going to be like, you know, living good, feeling great, living their best life. You have some folks who are living their best life tonight. Angela writes, cue the vote shaming in 3, 2, 1. Hopefully I didn't disappoint. I wouldn't call it vote shaming. I would call it putting things in their proper context. That's what I would say. Meaning that if you are an adult male or female and you're not voting, you are a threat to the community, period. There is no equivocation on it. We're not going to take two of theirs and they give us one back. It is what it is. P-E-R-I-O-D. I don't set the rules. I just abide by them. Tiffany writes, good morning. CG Dub writes, good morning, Choppers. Good morning, everybody. Fame writes, Lonzo F and Ball ruined my parlay last night. All of a sudden, dude is a 3-point marksman. You should have known that already. He's wearing better shoes this year. Lonzo Ball is going to be a hell of a ball player. Watch. And then his little brother is going to be like the number 1, 2, or 3 draft pick next year. So people can say whatever the hell they want to say about LeVar Ball, but we're going to watch him put two of his three boys are going to go as lottery picks, which means you're top 3, right? Top 10. Crazy, man. Crazy. Fast Pitch writes, happy election day. Hey, good to see you, Fast Pitch. Good morning. Iris writes, good morning, great people. Angela writes, I sincerely hope there are at least two new CPS board members. Really? Okay. Okay, let me see here. So who are your weak links? You know, from just the conversations that we had, and just a few conversations away from the microphone, just those impressions, I would say that there's definitely room for improvement, to say the least. And there's definitely room for improvement. But, you know, I thought it was quite interesting listening to them and getting the various responses. We shall see. I don't know. I mean, with the writing situation with Ozzie Davis, it's an X factor and you just don't know. I would say the door is definitely open. And beyond that, we shall see. Maybe the strategy for Pam Bowers will end up being where. You know what? I got a chance to talk with Pam Bowers yesterday on the show. And I broadcast it as his own separate live show. There was nobody inside the chop shop when we were doing it because it was just completely impromptu. You may or may not have gotten a message, but it's up on my Spreaker page right now, and you can check it out. I'll probably play some of that as well this show. Fame writes, no one really discussed the implications of issue 22. That is true. Fame writes, cat got shaken over the got. What? I don't know what he's saying. Brian writes, good morning. Repealing an earnings tax in hopes for a higher county tax vote in 2020. No comment on how the language will be, though. Broadway Stark, first of his name. Broadway Stark. I mean, how could you even rep that show right now? You know what I'm saying? Because that show was so terrible. That show ended so terribly. Look at what's happened. The dudes that were supposed to finish the show, they ran off to do some kind of new Star Wars trilogy, right? Because for the rest of our lives, they're going to be selling us Star Wars. For the rest of our lives. Get ready for it. As long as you are alive as a human being in America, there is always going to be a Star Wars movie that's either in the theaters or about to return to the theaters for the rest of your life. I'm telling you, it's just a complete lack of any creativity whatsoever. But look what happened. So these two dudes, they shortchange all the people that watch Game of Thrones so they can rush out and do a new project. That was the aforementioned project Star Wars trilogy, right? Which is still coming out. But guess what? They're not doing it. These bums got kicked off the project. Got kicked off the project. And then HBO has, they have about three different related to the universe of Game of Thrones series that are slated to come out, right? One of them was supposed to come out, you know, relatively soon. It was going to be set like 2,000 years or 1,000 years in the past, and it was going to go through all the old legends. That got canceled. That's how terrible the ending of Game of Thrones is, that it's created its own curse. The curse of Game of Thrones. You know, those two dudes will never, ever, ever be associated with. They're going to be forever cursed. We'll put it that way. They're going to be forever cursed. Anybody involved with making a decision on what happened in those last few episodes is going to be creatively cursed now and in the afterlife. That's how bad it was. That's how unsatisfied Game of Thrones fans were. Can you tell? And you ain't here talking about Broadway Stark, first of his name. But he writes, greetings. The Lord of the Chop Shop is present. Winter is coming. Okay, you want to be the Lord of the Chop Shop? Let me think about this. What does that mean exactly? Because, I mean, that's a lofty title. Let me think on it. Jordan writes, if you care about the children, do not vote for Eve Bolton for school board. Wow. That's a very strong opinion from somebody who has, I think, great insights into what is going on. That is a very strong opinion. Interesting. I've told you how I feel. Tracy writes, my son gets to vote for the first time today. Oh, he gets voting out here? Are we voting? Are we grown now? Are we out here voting and stuff? I love it. It's beautiful. We grown. Fame writes, wow, the lady is right. There's been more people in 20 minutes to Popeyes than there has been to my polling location in 2 hours. You know why? Because they're not selling chicken at the polling location, bruh. Don't try to make this complicated. It's real simple. If they were selling chicken at the polling places, then more people would be at the polling places to get the chicken. It's simple as that. Don't do that, man. Don't. It's election day, damn it, Fame. You are not going to defame black people on this show today. Don't come in here with those damn polling place versus Popeye chicken line comparisons. We don't need that today, man. We don't need that energy, bro. You know, your damn negative energy. You always saying being negative in here, man. We're going to celebrate the election process, the democratic process that has granted us as U.S. citizens so many of our rights, our inalienable rights. That's what we're going to do today, sir. You're here making Popeye chicken comparisons. Yeah, that Popeye chicken sandwich is back, and apparently it's not as big as it was before because fast food restaurants love to do bait and switch. That's what they do. Two for one. All of a sudden, the sandwich is like 15% smaller. Smart people know what I'm talking about. I grew up in the fast food age, man. Love being the age that I am. It's beautiful. I got a chance to see all the transitions to all the cool stuff. Just like you. Angela writes, Janaea isn't on my ballot. She's telling all. Okay, that's fair. That's fair. We are each allowed to vote however the hell we want to. It's called democracy. Don't you love it? Sharp writes, I agree with Angela and Jordan about their election choices. Okay. See, I tell people all the time, man, there are very many different opinions inside the chop shop. We do not. It's a microcosm of the larger community. Black folks do not all think the same. And they will never think the same. And even when we agree on certain issues, we might disagree on the tactics on how to address the issue. We are not a monolith. It is a diaspora, right? That's what it really is. It's a wide range of opinions and viewpoints that I just feel like the larger media just overlooks because they want to paint us all the same. It's easier that way, I guess. Fame writes, Pam, are you going to vote no on the new West Virginia incense bill? Mazon writes, my polling place is the City of Destiny pulpit pimp cousin's place. What? I usually don't vote there, but I didn't get to the Board of Education. That place is nice where the gym is, where I voted at. Damn shame. He's acting a fool because it definitely is a nice facility and it's worth the $8 million it is going for. Damn. No wonder Bishop Cousins was pulling the honeys like that, man. He had honeys all over the place. Let's call it what it is. He had honeys. Now, our mutual friend might not appreciate me saying that. But that's okay. Because we know the truth. The truth is that it is what it is. It's a great game of men and women. That's all it is. It's dating. Preachers can date too, as long as they're not married. Tracy writes, the Popeye's chicken sandwich is an experiment on the black community. What's in it? I don't know. I mean, at this point, I don't really have any strong inclination to get the chicken sandwich. I'm not trying to be elitist or anything like that. And let me add a caveat. I'm grown and all this shit can change in an instant. So if you see me at Popeye's chicken, don't come over trying to say, oh, Nate, I heard you on the air. Just let me eat the fucking chicken sandwich. Okay? So let me do that. And I throw it back in my face. I'm grown. I can change things when I want to. But as I sit here right now in a more sober and intellectual voice, I don't really have any interest in it. I really don't. And it's not just because of Popeyes. I mean, man, I spent my time at Popeyes. I ain't fronting. I spent my time there. But those days are past. I think I'm moving past drive-through fast food. Unless they're a sponsor. then I think I like it. Let me see. Bunky writes, what's up, Nate and the Choppers? Don't go agreeing with me just yet at Sharp. I'm a renegade voter. She writes, I have two Caucasians. Oh, boy. Oh, dear Lord. Dear Lord. I don't know which two you got. Are you talking about the school board? Or are you talking about the municipal court? I mean, that's fair. I don't have a problem voting for a white candidate at all. I have no problem voting for a white candidate as long as that candidate is aligned with what I think is important. And again, I think race matters. Race absolutely matters. We know it for sure. But there are paradigms and races in which you might have a white dude that's more closer in terms of his politics and policies than a black candidate. So what you going to do? You going to go with the black guy just because he's black? F no, we're not. Hell no. Mm-mm. He needs to get it together. That is hilarious. She said, I have two Caucasians. Like, I mean, really? I mean, I'm not surprised. That doesn't surprise me, Angela. I'll say it again. The black people I know are intelligent voters. Are there people out there that is going to take the Democrat slate or the Republican slate or the whatever slate and run with it? Sure. That you always going to have people that do those kind of things. And no matter what the scenario is, I just feel like the majority of people I know try to make an informed decision based on something. Something real. A fame writes, a dude was stabbed to death in Maryland over that goddamn chicken sandwich of Popeyes. Damn, Nathan. Shank means stabbed. TF, meaning the F? The fuck? Well, okay, I get you, man. But I mean, I heard that on the news, man. Everybody talking about the dude that got stabbed at the Popeyes. And you know what? The reason why I hesitate to do it is because it feels very typical, number one. And then number two, I don't know the details. From what I understand, they were standing in line and they got into an argument. Apparently, somebody tried to cut in line or something like that. Okay. Everybody's trying to make it seem like black people going crazy over chicken sandwiches. If you cut in line in front of somebody for anything, it's subject to cause sparks. You could be standing in line downtown at the Ferris wheel and somebody jumps in front of you. You just going to stand there? You ain't going to say nothing? Or you are. You going to let it go because you're a monk. You're a Shaolin monk. And you're really in touch with your chi and your inner energies and you're just not going to go there, right? But what if you're standing in line at the movie theater, somebody just jumps in front of you? What if you going to say something? So I don't know if it was about them fighting over a chicken sandwich or the disrespect that can sometimes happen when people come together as human beings and start interacting. Because you know, it's a whole lot of disrespectful mofos out here in this world today. You know it. I know it. Disrespectful people is at an all-time high. It really is. So, but the media wants to say, oh, it's about the Popeye's chicken. They could be in front of Kroger. They could have been in front of the barbershop. They could have been in front of church. It wouldn't have mattered because it had nothing to do with where they were, but it had to do with the interactions of the two individuals. Listen, and again, let me back up here with the Popeye's chicken. I was in line over there on the west side. I told you this, Coleraine Avenue. I was at the Popeye's standing there like, am I really going to get this chicken? That's what I realized. I thought it was $2. I didn't know it was $4. I'm like, $4? Damn. This is an adventure now. I'm not cheap, man. I've got kids. I'm thrifty. There's a difference. I'm thrifty. Thrifty. It's not cheap. I don't mind paying for things that are worth it. And ultimately, I stood there and I realized it's not worth it for me. It was funny because people was coming in and out and they were very sensitive about getting in line to other people. It had nothing to do with the item. It's about basic respect. Have you ever been in line somewhere and somebody just got in front of you? You'd be pissed like, man, you know, you could tell their friends or whatever. I'd be like, man, that's just not a good thing in America. You don't want to be jumping people in front of the line of people. You never know how people are. People get agitated real quick. Before you know it, tempers are flaring and bad things happen. Let me roll into my first break. It's the bottom of the hour, currently 8:35 a.m. It's a rainy election day in Cincinnati, Ohio. My name is Nathan Ivey. I flow, therefore I am, and we will be right back.
Wilson. Last year, basketball great LeBron James started the I Promise School in Akron, Ohio, which was designed to provide academics as well as social and emotional support to at-risk students. Well, he's now adding to that investment. The LeBron James Family Foundation is partnering with a hotel chain to build transitional housing for families whose children attend the I Promise School but are experiencing homelessness. BET founder Bob Johnson recently secured an exclusive deal in the Caribbean to expand his video game operations. The RLJ Companies is the majority owner of Caribbean Cage and will serve as the leading video lottery and video gaming terminal operator. The RLJ Companies has a sprawling business empire with interests in the entertainment, hotel franchise, automotive, and private equity industries. That's your Bloomberg Urban Report. I'm Donna Wilson.
This is State Senator Cecil Thomas here urging you to write in Ozzie Davis when you vote November 5th and vote for Eve Boatin and Carolyn Jones. And also on your ballot, vote Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board. They've been working hard together on our school board to improve our schools. Our kids deserve their consistent, strong leadership. Remember to vote November 5th. Write in Ozzie Davis and vote for Eve Boatin, Carolyn Jones, and vote for Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board.
This is Pamela Bowers, and I approve this message. Paid for by Bowers for the Board.
This is retired Judge Fanon Rucker. I served District 1 for 12 years, retiring from the bench this September. And when it comes to replacing me on the court, to me, there's one clear choice. Janaea Trotter Bratton. Janaea was born and raised in Cincinnati, started her legal career in the municipal court, and has worked for years as a civil rights lawyer. She's a leader in our community, recognized by the NAACP and by the YWCA as a rising star. As a judge, I know Janaea will make our justice system work for everyone, and she will do it with compassion and fairness. So whether you live in Avondale or Evanston, Walnut Hills, the West End, or Mount Auburn, the people of District 1 need Janaea Trotter Bratton on the bench. She is the only Democrat in this race, and she has my full support. So on November 5th, vote Janaea Trotter Bratton for judge.
Thank you, Judge Rucker. It is an honor to have your endorsement. I ask you to elect me, Janaea Trotter Bratton, as the first Black woman to be elected to this judicial seat.
Paid for by the committee to elect Janaea Trotter Bratton judge.
Hello, this is Ron Dumas. Now is the time to vote for the only candidate that's never prosecuted hundreds of our people, who has never testified in a judge's trial, and sadly, that judge was found guilty of that very offense.
Our people died for your right to vote. Please do not let anyone or anything take away your freedom of choice. There is freedom and power in your vote. I still remember the image of Miss Jane Pittman. Please don't let anyone assume that they have your vote just because they hand you a paper or a ticket. We are smart people.
Now is the time to vote for Judge Elisa Murphy, who is fair, just, and the most experienced, who has been on the bench a total of 16 and a half years, who has fought on the front lines with Judge Leslie Isaiah Gaines, who has over 25 years of experience as a defense attorney, who is from Evanston, and her family own the old Southern restaurant in the West End.
I am honored to follow Judge Leslie Isaiah Gaines, Judge John Berlew, and Judge John Skip West, who all came from this balanced, nonpartisan district. Please vote for your homegrown judge, Judge Elisa Murphy.
Paid for by Murphy for Judge.
This is State Senator Cecil Thomas here urging you to write in Ozzie Davis when you vote November 5th and vote for Eve Boatin and Carolyn Jones. And also on your ballot, vote Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board. They've been working hard together on our school board to improve our schools. Our kids deserve their consistent, strong leadership. Remember to vote November 5th. Write in Ozzie Davis and vote for Eve Boatin, Carolyn Jones, and vote for Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board.
This is Pamela Bowers, and I approve this message. Paid for by Bowers for the Board.
This is Bishop Bobby Hilton. I support Janea Trotta Bratton for District 1 judge. We must hold candidates to the highest moral standards. Janea shows integrity and is a Democrat that works hard for all those in our community. Janea did not and would not sell out her values just to get a seat. Her opponent cut a deal with Republicans to become a magistrate and has continued to be Republican even under the Trump administration, something she fails to mention. But Janea's opponent never forgets to mention her ties to a soul food restaurant ran decades ago, as if fried chicken will fool us into thinking she will fight for a fair judicial system. It's the same Republican playbook, assuming blacks are dumb enough to ignore facts and be swayed by down-home talk. Let's tell Miss Soul Food there's not enough fish plates in the world to make up for a lack of integrity and experience. Don't be fooled. A vote for the Republican is a vote for Trump's racist agenda. A vote for Janea is a vote for justice.
Paid for by the Hamilton County Democratic Party.
All right, we're done with that. We can get back to us. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Now, today is Tuesday. Hopefully, we're going to make it a tremendous Tuesday. Got to make sure you're eating right, getting healthy, because everything you eat right now, everything you do today will impact you on Thursday and Friday and Saturday. I want you to be a champion out there. Hey, good morning to the early risers, and viva la choppas. Long live the choppas. Good morning. If you like to share your thoughts today, 513-873-7134. Of course, that is my number. Open your mind. Before you open your mouth, we'll be all good. If not, a tiss-tiss with a flick of the wrist, and we'll move on. Hey, good morning to you. Good morning. Well, we are officially, it's political time, as if political time hasn't already started. The politics, man, on future elections in Cincinnati started like a year ago. Black Russia. I miss Black Russia, man, because he would just kick up dust. Give us something to talk about. It was always good for a good conversation. Free Black Russia. I'm down with that. Free Black Russia. Give us free. So today's off-year elections are state and local affairs. But if you think about it, I think they can tell us something about the national political scene. In one year. Will be the 2020 presidential elections. That's how close it is. 1 year, folks. The election is right around the corner. We don't have a lot of time. 1 year. 2 years after that, 2 years from today, city council and Cincinnati mayoral elections. Right around the corner. You're going to hear more and more people start to declare what they're going to do locally, especially now we're 1 year away. I say it will probably start tomorrow. As a matter of fact, tomorrow you're going to start hearing a lot of people announcing the election will be done. It's exactly 1 year. Boom. Let's go. Yeah, that's me. I am on the scene, typically. And NathanIvey.com is my website. What is this going to say? Could send us a message to what we can expect, maybe the momentum of the American electorate. What's going to happen? What's going to happen in Kentucky with Governor Matt Bevin? Matt Bevin is proudly pro-life against sanctuary cities. And he's against impeaching our president. So let's talk about it. You've got my number. Let's go straight to the phones. Let's get things cracking. Hey, good morning. Welcome to the show.
Good morning, Mr. Ivey. This is your West Side Connection, Drop Squad 52, coming to you live and direct from the left coast, also known as the People's Republic of California. Mr. Ivey, how are you doing this morning on this fine local election day?
I'm doing great. I'm pumped up, man. It's election day, and I can't wait to see what the people of, well, the city and various states are going to do.
Well, Mr. Ivey, I would like to discuss with you, sir, the status of Team Light Skin, also known as the People of Color Coalition, that are currently running as candidates for the Democratic Party nomination for president in 2020. Right now, we have Andrew Yang, we have Kamala Harris, we have Cory Booker, we have, I think that is it, because the white Hispanic Beto O'Rourke has dropped out. So we have, of those three candidates, I think Kamala Harris is polling the highest among Black Democrat primary voters in South Carolina, which will be the first primary election with a large amount of African-American voters, as opposed to Iowa and New Hampshire, which will come first starting in January. So, Mr. Ivey, at this point right now, Joe Biden is the only Democrat that is polling in the high 20s in South Carolina. And I think the closest to her is Kamala Harris. So, Mr. Ivey, with that being said, and the fact that Joe Biden is so closely tied to Barack Obama, do you think that the Democrats will have no choice but to give Joe Biden the nomination for 2020?
I think that his numbers against Trump should be taken as a serious consideration. I mean, wouldn't you? Make sense to me.
Yes, but Mr. Ivey, you are a true political person, and I know you have to have more than that, because Joe Biden right now is saying, because he's polling number four in Iowa, Nate. So they're saying, I'm talking about the Democrats and Joe Biden, they're saying that he can lose Iowa, he can lose New Hampshire, but when he gets to South Carolina, because of the Black vote, he's pretty much saying that no matter what I do, my Black folks are going to show up for me in South Carolina.
Well,
Nate, I mean, come on, Mr. Ivey. You have to have something to say to that.
I'll give you a little more substance to answer your question. I will. That was very, across the surface there. So here's how I really feel about it in response to your question, okay? Because your question was, what should the Democrats do? And my answer to that is the Democrats should do nothing. The Democrats in this election for 2020 should do nothing. They should allow the process to happen naturally with no filters, with no influence. They made that mistake in 2016. So that's what the Democrats should do. Sit it out. Let the process work itself out. If it's Joe Biden, it's Joe Biden. If it's not, it's not.
Okay. All right. So with that being said, let the process go through. So the Democrats, after Joe Biden, their front runner, who's really the highest one polling in the Black community, he loses Iowa, he loses New Hampshire, he gets to South Carolina, Nate, and he loses there. What do the Democrats do? Because you got Elizabeth Warren, you got Bernie Sanders, and you got Pete Buttigieg. So if Joe Biden doesn't do well in South Carolina with the Black vote, would that tell you, Mr. Ivey, that 2020 will not have the turnout of the Obama era, which was in the 90s? Hillary only got to 88.
Well, we know that's not going to happen. It's not like you're telling us something we cannot receive. There is no candidate in the race right now that had what Barack Obama had. There's no candidate right now where we see, oh, they got magic. We don't see that in these candidates. And then there are no candidates of color.
Their internal polling is showing that they will need that type of turnout. Because, Nate, we already know what the orange one is doing. We already know he is the first gangster president. He is going to do everything and anything he
needs
to do.
Which is a cute way for you to call
him
a crook.
To get his voters out.
Which is a cute kind of way for you to call him a crook. Without having to deal with the conscience because you supported a guy, a gangster president.
Nate, most politicians, he's a crook in
office.
Most politicians are crooks, Nate. And the ones who aren't, aren't crooks just haven't got caught yet.
That's a nice little thing to say, to play on people's cynicism about the system and those the elected officials. But I don't think that's true. They're not all the same.
Nate, the reason I mess with you on your show is because you're in social media, Nate. You run a media company. Shout out to Send Digital Media. So you see the numbers.
Reckon
you see what's happening in social media. and with what's going on with Facebook.
Where are we going with this?
And political ads.
Where are we
going
with this?
On with Twitter and political ads?
What's your point?
It's a reason, Nate.
What's your point? What's your point in
my
this?
My point is the black vote, it is changing, Nate. Okay?
The only reason
Joe Biden is even where he is because of the black vote, and that number, that demographic is 50 and over.
Yeah.
Joe Biden does not do well with the younger black vote.
True. And that's why I say,
okay, so
the Democrats, I think you're talking about the Democrat Party, they should sit back and let the people choose, let the primary process play out. And whoever wins the nomination, period.
Okay, but Nate, are you seriously saying that in this current climate of politics that the Democrats can afford to just sit back? Nate, do you see how much money Trump is raising? He's going to share that money with other Republicans across the country.
Probably.
Do you know how much Hillary... Well, I'm not going to ask you a rhetorical question. Hillary Clinton and the Democrat Party spent over $1 billion in 2016, Nate.
Did they? By themselves?
Combined.
Combined, okay.
Combined. The Clinton campaign and the Democratic committee.
Uh-huh.
Over $1 billion, Nate.
Okay, and what's the problem with that?
And the problem was... Back then, people were saying that Hillary wasn't out there trying to get that black vote, okay? So she was spending most of her money on TV ads. Okay, so if you think that the Democrats in 2020 can just sit back and let the process play out with the candidates that they have right now, all that means is they're conceding to Trump.
I don't think that means
Nate, why would you blow over $1 billion in a contest where your numbers are showing with a year to go, your numbers are showing in these battleground states. We're talking about the electoral college.
So what do you want the Democrats to do to rig the primary system so they can make Biden the winner? I mean, what are you suggesting?
I'm suggesting spend some money, get to these young black voters, Nate, because Trump is fighting for their vote. You've shown on your show, well, not shown, but you played audio, okay, of these events that are being held at the White House with all these black faces wearing red hats, okay? Because the media doesn't show it doesn't mean it's not happening. And you're closely in touch with social media. I mean, you see what they did to D.L. Hughley, Nate? They cut his show in an election year.
They cut the TV show, yeah. Well, that's par for the course. If you know anything about Urban One, they do that. What they do?
Yeah, because he's not generating numbers in the young black demographic.
Well, I'm not sure if that's true.
Nate, he old. Come on, D.L. Hughley older than you.
All I'm saying is that D.L. Hughley, he used to put clips of his show on YouTube, okay? And I would go to him.
Yeah.
And he consistently had 75, you know, nearly 100,000 plays. I mean,
right. They're
just kicking off what they're doing on YouTube anyway. I mean, I would measure that as success. I don't know what they were doing in terms of their cable numbers, but it's the digital
age. But Nate, you know, he ain't getting the clicks.
I can't say that. I don't know if that's true
because
or not.
Because if he was getting the clicks, just like Roland Martin when they dumped him.
I can't
say that. Roland Martin.
Clearly, that's not true about Roland Martin. Like I said, people need to look at things differently. I think you what you're trying to say is if he had numbers, they would have kept him. And what I'm telling you is not all those decisions are based upon numbers. Sometimes it's based
because
upon other things.
Yes. Okay. All right. But anyway, my whole point, I'm going to get off your line right now. But my whole point and reason for calling is that even in today's local election in Ohio, you got the governor in Kentucky today. Trump was there last night. You saw it probably on your local news.
Oh, yeah, Matt
but
Bevin.
They're not going to.
This is crazy nuts ass. Yeah.
But, Nate, all I'm saying is what I've been saying all along. The black vote in 2020 is crucial.
We know that.
Because.
We already know
because
that.
Because I'm. But, Nate, they ain't acting like they need it.
You're right.
It's almost, it's going to be the same thing again, and you're going to have all these black folks in here. Well, not all, but it's going to be a lot of black folks in here again, wringing their hands, and what happened?
They shouldn't
be. And now, Nate,
if they listen to Nathan, I'd be sure they shouldn't be. Because I was the one who brought up the fact that there was an article earlier this year in which it said that the DCCC, they, yes, instead of moving in the direction of the so-called squad and fostering, yes, and cultivating those type of candidates from the so-called squad,
yes,
you know what I'm talking about, AOC, yes, you know, yes, okay. So instead of doing that, they're going for candidates on the other side, you know what I'm saying? Instead of trying to, yes, attract the kind of people that are attracted to AOC, the article that I read said that the Democrat organization in charge of congressional races and funding for them was focused on trying to get white voters back from Trump. Stupidest thing I ever heard in my entire life. So we're hit to the game already.
It's always, I know, but see, Nate, that young vote that Barack Obama got in 2008 and then in 2012, that was fairly new in politics because the young vote was not reliable. Okay, you could register them, but they would not show up to vote. So when Obama did it twice, okay, then Trump hijacked it in 2016. Okay, Trump tapped into that same thing that Obama did because Mitt Romney didn't want to do it in 2012. Okay, so now that young vote, they want somebody like you said, like the AOCs, Ilhan Omar, Rashida Tlaib. And I think two of those, AOC and Ilhan Omar, are now supporting Bernie Sanders because they know, Nate, exactly what I've been telling you. Joe Biden is only getting that older black vote because it's reliable. And like you said, the DCCC, they're not ready to risk upwards of $1 billion on a campaign to get these unreliable young people to show up in numbers that the older black voters are showing up. But that's the dilemma that they're in, Nate. And at some point, they're going to have to wake up. Because if Joe Biden does not do well in South Carolina, Nate, I'm telling you, it's going to be a big change in the Democrat Party as far as the direction they're going to go in 2020.
A little point of fact because, here okay, is that more millennials voted for Clinton than Trump in 2016.
Yeah, I know.
Okay,
but where did those numbers come from?
You said that California, Trump had New the young York. Vote. You said Trump had the young vote. I don't know if that's true.
No, I didn't.
No,
I said
really
he
did.
He tapped into the internet.
No, you
like
said
Obama
he tapped into
did.
The young vote like Barack Obama did. Maybe that's what you meant, but that's not what you said.
Okay, that's possible. Okay. Yeah, but that's what I clarified. I just clarified what I said.
Clarify. It's a good way to put it.
Okay, so his numbers. The internet numbers, again, they're there, but for the Democrats, they need to get those young voters. The voters that Obama lost, well, not Obama, but Hillary lost in 2016. And again, Nate, all I'm saying is if you look at the numbers. So, like I said, Nate, in South Carolina, I think that'll be in February. We're a long way out. But as long as Joe Biden is sustaining that older black vote, he's going to stay on top in all the polling, followed by Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders. And right now, the way it's looking, Nate, the Democrats are going to have a problem if Joe Biden doesn't put up big numbers in the black community in South Carolina.
We'll see.
Because if those young people show up, Nate, in South Carolina, those young black voters, and they vote for Bernie or Elizabeth, then Democrats don't have a problem. So I'm going to hang up. Thanks for giving me this time, Mr. Ivey, see what other people think on this beautiful election day. Everybody's vote is a transaction. It is not a donation. Drop Squad 52, dropping science to anyone who wants to catch it. Peace.
Appreciate it. Wish I could get half that time back, but I cannot. Appreciate it. I'm going to make a bold prediction here, but I don't think that we're going to get a call from John today. I'm making a prediction that we will not get a phone call from John today. Would you like to know why? Smart people might have already pieced it together. I don't think that we're going to get a call from John today. It's a little bit of a riddle. It's like a current event riddle. And so you've got to know what's going on current event wise in terms of politics and significance of today. You've got to have some insights into John and his particular personality. And I'll let you think about it for a second. And while we're thinking about it, just to help us meditate, let it marinate, right? I want to play a video. I don't know if it's gone viral or not, but this is a Trump supporter, and she spits a freestyle wearing a giant MAGA hat. Now, why am I playing this? Because it's a sister. It's a sister doing this. Check this out.
Yeah, it's that MAGA girl. It should be obvious because you know that we run the world. And I got all these liberals that he hating on me. They keep saying white is what she want to be. But all I want to do is set the captives free and make enough noise to say the babies. And get my people all welfare. They say I'm crazy in that. I don't care. Ayy, but it's time for us to wake up. I swear some of the shit you can't make up. Hey, we got 100 different genders. It don't matter because Trump is the winner.
Hey, call me what you want, cause that don't matter, boy. I just speak the truth, that's something they don't understand. Got these white liberals trying to tell me who I am. Don't put me in groups, cause I'm my own man. I said I wasn't Democrat and lost a few friends. Radio by playing me, I lost a few fans. So tell me I'm a victim, cause I'm power in my hands.
Man, I was getting it for a minute there. Yeah, that's MAGA hat girl with her rap. She said the white liberals is trying to trying to tell us what to think. Tight beat. Good flow. The MAGA hat has to go. I mean, it's like an extra raw. It looks like a Mario Luigi hat. It's so big. Now, where in the hell do you buy something like that? You got to understand. I love human beings, man. I mean, just think about the mentality of the person who said, you know what? Oh, you don't like the MAGA hat? Okay, I'm going to make an extra large MAGA hat. It's like, I don't know, man. I don't know who could actually, what human being could actually wear that hat. I don't know. I don't know, man. It's a lot of big-headed mofos out there, but that is a really big MAGA hat. She had some, she was spitting fire. Let's listen again. That's MAGA hat girl. Break it down now. Here we go now. Introducing MAGA.
Yeah, it's that MAGA girl. It should be obvious because you know that we run the world. And I got all these liberals that he hating on me. They keep saying white is what she want to be. But all I want to do is set the captives free and make enough noise to say the baby. And get my people all welfare. They say I'm crazy in that. I don't care. Ayy, but it's time for us to wake up. I swear some of the shit you can't make up. Hey, we got 100 different genders. It don't matter cause Trump is the winner.
Hey, we got 100 different genders. It don't matter cause Trump is the winner. She done for that one. We got 100 different genders. No, we don't. We just got 57. People always exaggerate now here, man. Hey, I need a little pick-me-up in the morning on the election. This is an election day rap. See, this is how Trump is so far ahead of Democrats. They got black females doing viral videos. What are the Democrats doing? What are the Democrats doing? Nothing. Nothing like this anyway. Check this out.
And get my people all welfare. Oh, yeah. They say I'm crazy in that. I don't care. Ayy, but it's time for us to wake up. I swear some of the shit you can't make up. Hey, we got 100 different genders. It don't matter cause Trump is the winner. Ayy.
Hey, it's an MAGA boy. Call me what you want cause that don't matter, boy. I just speak the truth, that's something they don't understand. Got these white liberals trying to tell me who I am. Don't put me in groups cause I'm
white liberals trying to tell me who I am. I'm sure that where you at, Broadway Stark, I'm sure you appreciate that flow. Her face is dumb at the end of this video. Do you want to see this? Hold on, let me post it in Chop Shop for you. I know you do. I know you do. You don't have to say nothing. People will shame you, but don't be ashamed. You don't have to be ashamed. Be who you are on the Nathan Ivy Show. Let me find this for you. You can look at Big Hat Maggot Girl. Here she go. There she is. I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to put this directly inside the chop shop for your morning enjoyment. Don't say I don't do nothing for you, boo. There it is. Bang. Bang. Clue Magic writes, she whack. Oh, you just going to cut straight through the bullshit, huh? Tanika writes, I can see Trump jamming to this. Oh, you know Trump is loving this. He was probably light on his toes. Like, what? Hey. Now, watch Diamond and Silk or Rhinestone and Burlap. Watch them come out with their own little video. Remember that ridiculous? Now, that's a Trump video right there. That's a rap video. Remember that rap video that Rhinestone and Burlap made? It was terrible. It was the most terrible thing ever. Let me see if I can find it. I didn't even want to bring it up. It was so terrible. Mike Davis writes, hey, I can't hate. I like the beat. Yeah, I mean, got me. I was doing a little big man two-step in my seat. In my seat here, yeah. Hey. Oh, man. CG Dub writes, as if we're the only ones on welfare, right? She writes, she's a clown. I'm sorry, I added the effing. She did not say that. You can check out the video for yourself and look at that big hat. If she take the damn hat off, but the hat is what makes you, draws you in to see the video. It's like, what? So that it's a little bit of a bait and switch. She put that hat on like, oh, look at this clown. Then you tune in and the beat's not too bad. The flow was decent. I can't hate on her flow. Can't hate on it. Love it. A dude was stabbed to death in Maryland. Okay, we got that. I mean, was somebody really stabbed over a chicken sandwich? Or was it all? It's just like people. It's like two guys get into a fight over a basketball during a basketball game. And people say, oh, this is a shame. They're fighting over a basketball game. It's not about the game. It's about men. It's about being disrespected at some point. It ain't got nothing to do with the game. Now it's two steps, three steps beyond the game. That's probably what happened in Popeyes. Somebody was standing in line and somebody came up and got in front of them. Now, there's a lot of people that would let that go. They'd let that go. You know, honestly, I've handled it. That's happened to me. Honestly, I've handled it a couple different ways. I've been confrontational with it and I've let it go depending on, you know, my surroundings and who I was with. Okay, so I understand. You know, if you stand in line for anything, you could be standing in line to get a pack of chewing gum. It has nothing to do about the purchase. It's about your time and feeling disrespected. So the media wants to make it thing like black people arguing over chicken. I don't know if that's what really happened. It was probably they were in line to get some chicken, and then somebody did something disrespectful, because like I told you, there's a lot of disrespectful mofos walking around here, running around here in the world today, talking slick and greasy, to steal a phrase from Fame, and, you know, talking super reckless. I don't know what the hell, but sometimes they meet people who are just not about it, and things happen. And that's probably what happened with this chicken sandwich. This is about what will benefit the rich versus the poor. He said, shit is whack. Just straight to it, huh? Fast Pitch, right? She said, hate no me like the city girls, right? He writes, shit ball bars. Damn. TNT writes, weirdo. Yeah, that is a little weird. It is a little weird. I mean, but that's just a MAGA. That's people's mentality in capitalism. It's like, oh, you got a problem with the MAGA hat? Okay, well, I'm going to order a super big giant MAGA hat. Now, how you feel about that? And the reason why these super giant MAGA hats exist is because people were responding to it. Like, that's the reason why you had these black dudes run around putting MAGA hats on, going out to dinner with their fiance and all this kind of stuff. Then you want to get mad because, you know, somebody do something to your food or they start clowning you. That actually happened. Like a real life story. Black dudes on a date with his fiance or his girlfriend and then her mother. And he wears a MAGA hat to dinner. Now, what kind of idiot does that? What kind of idiot? You shouldn't have a hat on, period, fool. That's number one. Where's your daddy at? He didn't teach you how to be a man. Take your damn hat off when you're in the house, man. He walk around just to make a point. So he made a point. And some of the black people that worked in the kitchen was like, oh, you see this fool? And they started giving him the business right in front of him. He made a big deal out of it. He caused it. You don't go out on a date on a woman trying to make no damn political statements. Make your political statements when you're not on a date, fool. Better yet, you with her mama? Who does that? I'm not saying you can't make political statements, but there's a time and a place for everything. The first date with her mama is not the time for you to wear your MAGA hat and talk about why you love being a black Republican. Save all that, man. Save all of that. These cats don't know how to be men these days, man. It's a damn shame. Where are they daddies at? Where are the daddies at? Where are the daddies? Let me go to the phones here. I got I'm not sure what happened. Hey, Tracy, I just had Tracy on the line. I was going straight to her. Where the daddies at? Boy. Bunky writes, Negroes and their chicken sandwiches. I've been telling you all for years now, everyone should not be allowed to replicate themselves. There is a certain segment in black society that has been on socially engineered, and we've got to separate. Okay. We got to separate from the other black folks that's been socially engineered to do us all harm and or to embarrass us. Okay, got it. Let me go to the phones. We got Tracy on the line. Good morning, Tracy.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. Doing great. What's going on?
I meant to call you yesterday. I need you to help settle a debate in my house. And trust me, this is relatable to what's going on in the world. I'm not just calling to change the subject. But we had a situation Sunday at my home, and I just need to know what everybody would do. So my husband took me out for my birthday on Saturday, and we didn't come home. We stayed out at a local hotel, you know, being grown. And so Sunday morning, we get a call from my son, my younger son, and he said, what did you do to the alarm? What happened was my older son was going to work. He set the alarm to keep his little brother safe, but he set it for away instead of stay. So when my younger son got up, the motion in the house was detected and the alarm went off. So we thought the police were on their way. And I told my younger son, do not open the front door if the police come. My husband says, he can open the door. He should open the door. And I said, no, because he really can't prove that he lives there. He doesn't have any ID. I said, people are getting shot in their homes now. Keep the door closed. So we're going back and forth with my son. Open it, close it, open it, close it. And he was confused. We left. We got there. The police didn't even come there. Like, I don't even know why ADT didn't even notify him. But I just want to know, was I wrong or was my husband wrong? What would you do? What would you tell your child? You had a situation where they were home alone. My son is 15, and he didn't know whether to open the door or not if the police came. That's been bothering me for a few days.
That's a great question. Real life. Let me. I don't have a quick answer. Let me ponder that for a second. And let's. Have you posted that in Chop Shop?
If the choppers have an answer, just write it because I'm looking. Because
okay,
you know it's real out here, and I didn't know how to deal with that. That was my first instinct.
Okay, thank you for sharing. I appreciate it.
All right, bye.
Yeah, real life situation here. What would you do? What do you tell your child? Man, that's very interesting because, and keeping in mind, she has two boys. One, I believe, is 18. The other is nearly 18. I believe. If I'm wrong about that, I apologize. But so they're older. That's a damn good question in these days and times. Post Amber Geiger, post Tatiana Jefferson. Wow. Because, let me think, what would be my thought? Let me put myself in that situation as little Buddha. You know, that's tough. That's a tough one. Cause on one hand, I feel like she's at home and I want her to answer the door because depending on the officer, it could escalate. You know, officer gets a burglary alarm. And I just don't know the legal standing on this, but does that give them probable cause to enter the house even if somebody doesn't answer the door? Can they knock the door down? Okay, that's what I'm thinking. And then secondly, that's what happened with Tatiana Jefferson. They didn't go to the door. They went around the back. He shot her through the window. That's a tough one. That is a very tough one. I mean, but we got to come up with an answer. So for me, I would tell her, you know, it goes either ways, but I would tell her to answer the door. I think I would tell her to answer the door. That's my answer. I would tell her to answer the door. I think I agree with your husband. Don't be mad at me. I don't want to start nothing in the household. Now, that's where I'm taking us. Because you asked me the question, so I want to give you an answer before I start reading other people's answer. At least I've got a foundation for which to continue the conversation with. Okay? But that's what I think. What do you think, Choppas? Currently 9:15 a.m. Tanika writes, I agree, Nate. That's what the GOT creators get. They left us high and dry. They did. I mean, they're going to be cursed. Just a wonderfully rich, deep show. You're talking about 9-10 seasons. That's 7-8 years, if not longer. And you end like that? They're forever going to be cursed. Forever. Drop writes, Choppas, what do you have to lose? Sleepy Joe is the only desperate Democrat that didn't get at least 88% of the ADOS vote. I don't know if he's going to get 88% of the ADOS vote. I don't know about that. And despite what the poll numbers say, poll numbers are subject to change. You know, my answer to your question again is the Democrats should stay out of it. Let the process do what the process is supposed to do. They made that mistake in 2016. Don't think the Russians are not waiting to break right back into the DNC servers to release some more dirty laundry right before Election Day. You know, that was the purpose of all of that. The purpose of that was to help Trump seem as if he was a credible guy, and it worked for a lot of people. Let's go back to the phone, shall we? Good morning. Welcome to the show.
Hey, brother 252. Good morning, sir.
Hey, what up, 252? It's been a minute.
Hey, man. Hey, yeah, it's been a while, man. Good to hear you.
Yeah, good to hear you too, man. Welcome.
Man, thank you, man. Tracy got me stumped. That's a real situation, man, because I remember when Trayvon Martin was killed, my oldest son had just got his first job, just got his license. He was 16. And we had to think differently. You know, back then, I don't think we were seeing a lot of issues popping up around the country, but it was real to us. And now this one is real. And I'll tell you something else, man. I live in a mixed neighborhood, but predominantly white. And my neighbors, my kids even have a school teacher, a retired teacher, lives a couple doors down. And she talked to my boys, and she knows them very well. I mean, they know us very well. So initially, I'm thinking, nah, don't open the door, because they really going to have some recognition. And I'll give you an example, because every time I got four kids, man. Every time I went to the bank, I can take my daughter to the doctor's office. These folks don't think you're supposed to be there. And it's continual, man. And somebody will probably try to stand me down, but I've done this. And I was just talking to my mother-in-law the other day. So I think it's based on your kid's intelligence. You know, hey, if you got a kid that's going to pop off if they open the door, hey, remember what happened to those sisters in Dallas. I mean, she didn't even have a chance to play. But, you know, if you got kids, you know, if you got kids with an ID, if they can present an ID, if they can represent their home very well, it's something to think about. I think it's sad that we have to, you know, that it's come to that day. But I know one thing. I'm not for calling the cop to settle a settled issue no more. I mean, I don't think it'll come to that. But that's tough. That's tough. But Tracy, I will say, definitely, you know, I think you and your husband will definitely have a small debate, a family back and forth with that. But you know, just try not to get angry with the situation we're in. You know, we just got to keep fighting and work it out. And I'm not saying you will, Tracy, but yeah, I seen you wavering on that one day a little bit, Nate. I think if Junior was a little older, you might want to answer that a little quicker.
Well, I mean, you know, I was trying to think about my daughter because she's 14. It's a gamble either way. Either way, it's a gamble.
Absolutely.
But the reason I thought that is because, and I guess I'm kind of revealing, I don't currently have an alarm system in our house. But if we did, my daughter would be well-versed on what to do. I like to think we would have went through this, call it a rehearsal, you know, verbally or whatever, to make sure that, you know, we cover that situation. Like, what if we trip it accidentally and the police come to your door? I mean, to me, that's a question I think that is reasonable to speculate. So, I mean, I think that I would tell her to open the door and just kind of deal with it that way. I think that's what I would say.
Yeah, so just... Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, I'm done.
But yeah, just like, and I guess sort of like, you know, changing your batteries in your smoke detector when time goes back. You know, just go over with your kids your alarm code. Typically, if the alarm company calls, they just probably just want a password, and they can settle that.
Yeah, because I'm sure that's common, right? I mean, listen, this technology is not foolproof. Accidents happen. I'm sure it's very common for, you know, those kind of scenarios to happen and police get called or something like that. I'm sure it's very common.
Yeah. Hey, man, thanks for letting me chime in.
Yeah, thank you for making the call, man. That's Brother 252, man. Good to hear from you. Chiming in on Tracy's scenario there. I would have to believe that police, and again, look at Tatiana Jefferson. That's what happens with police. It's not that I have a problem with police. It's just that it's the wild inconsistencies when they show up and you never know who's going to show up. And see, that's what happens with the black community. People mislook at that. Like Jay-Z running around here talking about, you know, kids brought up in a single parent household with just a mother are more likely to get into police shootings. Well, tell that to Tatiana Jefferson. You know what I'm saying? What the hell is Jay-Z talking about? I don't believe that. Do you? That doesn't ring true to me at all. I don't believe that. So I would have to, you never know what you're going to get, but I think I would go with that. Unless somebody says in here they can change my mind, and not that that is your purpose or what you're trying to do at all. I'm just saying, we're just having a conversation. I'm open to what you think. Has anyone seen the new movie Harriet Tubman? If you have, get your thoughts ready. I want to talk about it. And, you know, for the remainder of the show, probably from the bottom of the hour, we're going to look back and listen to some of the audio of the various candidates that we had on. Why not, right? But for now, let's go back to the phones. Good morning. Welcome to the show.
Hi, good morning, Nathan. How are you today?
Hey, good morning, Fame.
Yes, sir. Real quick before I start, the Cincinnati Bengals will get their first win this weekend. They're 10-point underdogs. Bet heavy on the Bengals. They will win the game outright.
Against who?
I promise you, Baltimore. Baltimore is going to be drunk with power over their win over New England. You know, everybody's trying to, you know, paint Tom Brady as the face of white supremacy in the NFL, which I don't know why the dude got black kids. He ain't never bothered nobody. Them ain't his nieces. Those are his kids. Those black kids. And it's like, dude ain't never bothered nobody. He ain't never done nothing to nobody. But everybody's painting Lamar Jackson as God because of one win over there. They're going to be drunk with power. And the Bengals, like I told you the last time, to take the Bengals over Baltimore, the Bengals roster matches up with Baltimore's. The Bengals will win this game outright. And they're starting a new quarterback. And new quarterbacks on their first start always do well because there's no film on them. You can't break them down. You don't know what they're going to do. You don't know their tendencies.
Dropping science. Okay.
You know, bet the farm on the Bengals. Now, as far as Tracy, She need to let the boy answer the door. The young man should answer the door because, one, he is a young man. He's a man. There's just certain things he needs to, you know, face in life. You know, mom, you know, I mean, for lack of a better term, you know, you can't breastfeed him all your life. There's certain things you can't protect him from. I'm not saying you're not protecting him from a police death, but there's just certain things that, you know, he's just got to be able to handle and gain experience at handling. One of them is a police interaction. And protecting his home and letting the police know in a very calm and cool manner, I live here, but I'm a minor. My parents are away celebrating my mom's birthday. You know, I agree with her husband. He should have opened the door. I don't know. I forgot. I don't know if she said what ultimately happened, but I believe the boy should have opened the door. You know, this ain't no 9-year-old. You saying, I'm about to go. Don't answer the door for nobody. This is a teenager in high school. You know, it's kind of a rite of passage, if you will, unwritten rite of passage.
I agree with you. Open the door. And sidebar, Ben Thomas writes, the Bengals about to get curb stomped.
Ben Thomas wrote that from hell?
All the way.
He need to go back to hell. Listen, I mean, because I'm a professional. Don't insult me. If Jimmy the Greek said that, you wouldn't have said nothing, Ben Thomas. But because I'm black, everybody wants to think they can do it better. I'm the goddamn professional. Don't fucking insult me. Now.
4 minutes, man. 4 minutes.
Now, as far as you were wrong about Tatiana Ali, whatever her name was, the girl in Fort Worth.
Jefferson.
She grew up with a single parent. Because remember, the mom and dad ain't getting along. Remember, they was tripping on the burial. The funeral was supposed to be at TD Jake's church. And the dad stepped in like, nah, I got dough. I took a life insurance policy out on her. So there was friction there. So, you know, but yeah, I know that was a different situation. I'm just basically saying you messed that one up. That was a bad example.
Well, we see it differently.
Okay. But as far as this, you know, the chicken out there in Maryland, I disagree again. I don't think that
with the stabbing.
Yeah, I think the basketball example was a bad thing. Basketball is competition. You know, dudes out there hooping in front of their girls and whatnot, they kids, you know, I'm not going to go home not looking like daddy, not feeling like daddy. Let some dude bang on me, dunk on me, bang threes in my face, cross me up. You know, at some point, my man pride going to step in. You cutting in line, being disrespectful and disorderly over a chicken sandwich is indicative of the black stereotype of chicken, loving chicken. So when somebody at your job makes a chicken joke, I don't want to hear nothing. Because y'all proving it right here by chasing down this chicken sandwich, lining up in the drive-thru 2 hours before they open just to be the first to get that chicken sandwich for the day.
And see, that's where we disagree, because I think that the location of where the argument happened is irrelevant. They just happened to be in line for a chicken sandwich. They could have been at the convenience store. They could have been the place where they get gas. It's really about the interaction between them two men. Just like in basketball, I've seen dudes get slammed in their head over the smallest shit ever. And I'm thinking, damn, y'all fighting over basketball? But to those two men, it wasn't about basketball. It was one man felt disrespected by another.
Right. Over chicken.
No.
Whether it was over it was over chicken.
Over cutting.
I'm getting the chicken sandwich first.
It wouldn't matter.
I was here, bruh.
You could be standing at the ATM. You could be standing to get some milk. It don't matter.
Oh, if it's the last of the milk, it's the last of the milk. You know, people know these chicken sandwiches bound to run out real soon.
It was irrational
N-word tree.
I think you want it to be about the chicken, because then it'll justify some things that you want to say about the black community. That's what
The Boondocks, I mean, this is life imitating art. The Boondocks did this episode 10 years ago about Negroes would be crazy over going crazy over chicken. A chicken sandwich.
What a stretch.
I'm not trying everybody, to like. Sometimes is that. Sometimes is that. Like as Rakim said, since you like hip hop so much, sometimes it's that simple but quite clever. While you trying to talk about a stretch? My break is done. I got to go back and help some seniors cast their ballots. I'm doing my civic duty, my civilian duties today. I will holler at you at a future moon, brother. Oh,
that's fame. I don't know if he should be racked or not. I don't know. I have no idea. But he really wants it to be about the chicken sandwiches. It's not about the chicken, man. When two men feel disrespected, that's what happens. But you just want to run with it to make it a stereotype about the black community because that fits the way you want to look at us. It's damn disgusting. The first time we did that, I feel it was apropos this morning. Once you get pumped up, it's election day, and that's a classic song. It's not the first time we've done that. He's earned it. He's put the flows in. Okay, let me work backwards here. Want to make sure I get many in. Cam Rice, bonjour, good morning, shalom, peace. Nathan in the chop chop shop. Mazone writes, I seen a Halloween costume of someone wearing a Game of Thrones sign over a garbage bag. Standing next to a pile of garbage on the street. It was funny as hell. I'm telling you. I didn't talk about Game of Thrones a whole lot because I didn't want to embarrass myself, but let's just say it was my little mindless disengagement. I missed entire seasons. Man, I missed two seasons in a row, yo. And then I caught some time, watched them all, Ben watched two seasons of Game of Thrones. Classic times. Classic. They get to the end and they disappointed all of us. All of us. And they'll be cursed creatively for the rest of their lives. Tracy writes, I'm going to make my own chicken sandwich. F Popeyes. They were backed up this morning. Do they serve breakfast or something? No, the chicken sandwiches came back. Yeah, the chicken sandwich is back at Popeyes. The review is that they're a little bit smaller now, and I'm not surprised by that. I could have anticipated it before. In fact, I don't remember saying it, but I wouldn't be surprised if I did say it, and I just don't remember saying it. Because that's what they do in fast food. They put out something real cool, or they give you a 2-for-1 special, 3-for-1 special. Oh, I'm getting my favorite sandwich. But what you don't realize is that this was a decision made by the executive board a year ago. And it's all about how they're going to get more profits by slowly reducing the size of the sandwich by 20%, 15%, 30%. To you, it's nearly imperceptible. But to them, it equals big dollars in the bank. They do this all the time, man. I've done the fast food thing. I'm not trying to be holier than thou. I've done the healthy living thing. I went through my fast food teenager. All about it, man. But as I get older now, I'm a man in my 40s now. I can't keep eating that trash. It'll kill me. It's not good for your brain function, and I need my brain to function. Cassandra Rice, fame killed two birds with one stone. Buy some sandwiches and sell them for $5 at the polls. Exactly. Now, if you showed up with like 20 sandwiches, and they've got some things you can purchase, like some big old things and like a zipper. It's like a thermal thing. It'll keep food inside of it really, really warm. Man, you make it. Just spend. Listen, these sandwiches are $5. You make a dollar on every sandwich? Come on, man. I don't get mad at people about their chicken sandwiches because I understand that people, there are fast food addictions. Like, fast food is highly addictive. It's highly addictive. And you combine that with the little fizz of a soft drink and the taste of some golden brown French fries. Man, there's people that's been eating that shit for 20, 30 years. It's hard for them to wean themselves off of it. It's like a drug. And it's all empty calories that ultimately will have an impact on your cognitive abilities, your critical thinking abilities. So, again, these are adults. You know, I don't want to criticize you for how you spend your money. You might be spending your money ways. I'm like, man, that's frivolous as hell. But that's your money. So if that's what you want to do, great. I just analyze and interpret. I'm a cultural observer. That's what I do. I look at the world and observe. As was the old tagline of Sister Speak. Look at the world and observe. Bunky Rice Bishop had hoes and 8 years didn't make the cut. He said 8 years. So her name is 8 years now. That's a long time to date somebody. But you know what? I don't think that's a problem with it. There's nothing wrong with dating for 8 or 9 years if you're happy. Who says you got to get married? You don't have to get married. This incredible pressure to get married is if that's the only way. That's the only way for the people that choose that way. You don't have to. Or you might choose to. You might say, that's exactly the way I want to go. I'm very much so a live and let live kind of person. If you ain't bothering me, we cool. Do whatever you want to do. Angela writes, I think Eve Bolton may go down. Okay. It's really about who she's replaced with. Because on that side, what do you got? You got Marlena and you got Ben Lindy. Okay. Yeah. And Heather Couch, who we didn't get a chance to talk with. It's going to be quite interesting. We shall see. Nathan is going to get that chicken sandwich, y'all. And if I do, I'll tell you. I don't think I am. I don't really have any personal inclination. I mean, I'm never that hungry where I got to stop at a fast food place. I live in Cincinnati. Okay. If I'm hungry, I'll go to the grocery store and I like to prepare my food. I know it's right that way. I got a little OCD in me, y'all, just a little bit. So no, I'm not. And then I'm past the point of like wanting to go get the chicken sandwich so I can report back to you. We way past that. I mean, at this point, get the chicken sandwich and tell me what you think. So I don't know, man. I mean, is it inconceivable that one day I might eat a Popeye's chicken sandwich? Nothing is impossible, but I don't see it. And I'm not boycotting it. I don't have a problem with it. It's just not for me. You know, enjoy. Enjoy. In no way do I think I says anything about you because, man, most people in America has enjoyed fast food at some point in their life. Now, you might be brand new. You be on your workout regimen. You don't do that for a year or two, huh? But at some point, you did. Stop fronting. I keep it real with you. I've gone through all of that. I did my fast food stuff. But that was back when fast food was like a brand new industry and was exploding. You had all these different vendors and different selections. Again, if you're in your 40s, you live through all of that. I've done that. Now, I'd rather cook my own food. Make sure, that way I know it's right. Tracy writes, Lord of the Chop Shop. Rolling. Yeah, he's Lord of the Chop Shop now. So I guess I'm supposed to be Bran, right? Because you're Lord of the Chop Shop. I'm Bran. Oh, my God. TNT's in the house. Good to see you. Jordan writes, she's done and she knows it. Is that right? Tracy writes, meanwhile, she writes, black people are waiting in line for hours for a chicken sandwich. That is crazy. That's because they like chicken and they want to see what everybody's talking about. There's a lesson in that. Mike writes, good morning, choppers. Nate, it's the item that makes people stand in line. Popeye's chicken is mostly in black, brown community. Why? Angela writes, get Cecil on the phone to explain the benefits of voting for Eve Bolton. That's a good one, Angela. That's a good one. Speaking of which, we got to take a break. Good morning. Thank you for being here. Today is election day. Today is the day when we finally can be done with this. Although I've enjoyed this election season, I have learned quite a bit. It has been quite interesting. And these are very crucial races. The municipal court races are very crucial. very crucial. And we'll pick back up and talk about it all on the other side. Let me leave my number right here for you. 513-873-7134. I want to leave an impression inside of your brain. 513-873-7134. If you haven't already done so, just take this time to lock me into your phone. Boom, we done. That way I'm just one or two buttons away. There it is. Nathan Ivey with you. It's a beautiful election day in the city of Cincinnati. And the flow and the show will return right after a few messages.
The Bloomberg Urban Report. I'm Donna Wilson. Last year, basketball great LeBron James started the I Promise School in Akron, Ohio, which was designed to provide academics as well as social and emotional support to at-risk students. Well, he's now adding to that investment. The LeBron James Family Foundation is partnering with a hotel chain to build transitional housing for families whose children attend the I Promise School but are experiencing homelessness. BET founder Bob Johnson recently secured an exclusive deal in the Caribbean to expand his video game operations. The RLJ Companies is the majority owner of Caribbean Cage and will serve as the leading video lottery and video gaming terminal operator. The RLJ Companies has a sprawling business empire with interests in the entertainment, hotel franchise, automotive, and private equity industries. That's your Bloomberg Urban Report. I'm Donna Wilson.
This is State Senator Cecil Thomas here, urging you to write in Ozzie Davis when you vote November 5th and vote for Eve Boatin and Carolyn Jones. And also on your ballot, vote Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board. They've been working hard together on our school board to improve our schools. Our kids deserve their consistent, strong leadership. Remember to vote November 5th. Write in Ozzie Davis and vote for Eve Boatin, Carolyn Jones, and vote for Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board.
This is Pamela Bowers, and I approve this message. Paid for by Bowers for the Board.
This is retired Judge Fanon Rucker. I served District 1 for 12 years, retiring from the bench this September. And when it comes to replacing me on the court, to me, there's one clear choice. Janaea Trotter Bratton. Janaea was born and raised in Cincinnati, started her legal career in the municipal court, and has worked for years as a civil rights lawyer. She's a leader in our community, recognized by the NAACP and by the YWCA as a rising star. As a judge, I know Janaea will make our justice system work for everyone, and she will do it with compassion and fairness. So whether you live in Avondale or Evanston, Walnut Hills, the West End, or Mount Auburn, the people of District 1 need Janaea Trotter Bratton on the bench. She is the only Democrat in this race, and she has my full support. So on November 5th, vote Janaea Trotter Bratton for judge.
Thank you, Judge Rucker. It is an honor to have your endorsement. I ask you to elect me, Janaea Trotter Bratton, as the first Black woman to be elected to this judicial seat.
Paid for by the committee to elect Janaea Trotter Bratton judge.
Hello, this is Ron Dumas. Now is the time to vote for the only candidate that's never prosecuted hundreds of our people, who has never testified in a judge's trial, and sadly, that judge was found guilty of that very offense.
Our people died for your right to vote. Please do not let anyone or anything take away your freedom of choice. There is freedom and power in your vote. I still remember the image of Miss Jane Pittman. Please don't let anyone assume that they have your vote just because they hand you a paper or a ticket. We are smart people.
Now is the time to vote for Judge Elisa Murphy, who is fair, just, and the most experienced, who has been on the bench a total of 16 and a half years, who has fought on the front lines with Judge Leslie Isaiah Gaines, who has over 25 years of experience as a defense attorney, who is from Evanston, and her family owned the old Southern restaurant in the West End.
I am honored to follow Judge Leslie Isaiah Gaines, Judge John Berlew, and Judge John Skip West, who all came from this balanced, nonpartisan district. Please vote for your homegrown judge, Judge Elisa Murphy.
Paid for by Murphy for Judge.
This is State Senator Cecil Thomas here, urging you to write in Ozzie Davis when you vote November 5th and vote for Eve Boatin and Carolyn Jones. And also on your ballot, vote Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board. They've been working hard together on our school board to improve our schools. Our kids deserve their consistent, strong leadership. Remember to vote November 5th. Write in Ozzie Davis and vote for Eve Boatin, Carolyn Jones, and vote for Pam Bowers for Cincinnati School Board.
This is Pamela Bowers, and I approve this message. Paid for by Bowers for the Board.
This is Bishop Bobby Hilton. I support Janaea Trotter Bratton for District 1 Judge. We must hold candidates to the highest moral standards. Janaea shows integrity and is a Democrat that works hard for all those in our community. Janaea did not and would not sell out her values just to get a seat. Her opponent cut a deal with Republicans to become a magistrate and has continued to be Republican even under the Trump administration, something she fails to mention. But Janaea's opponent never forgets to mention her ties to a soul food restaurant ran decades ago, as if fried chicken will fool us into thinking she will fight for a fair judicial system. It's the same Republican playbook, assuming blacks are dumb enough to ignore facts and be swayed by down-home talk. Let's tell Miss Soul Food there's not enough fish plates in the world to make up for a lack of integrity and experience. Don't be fooled. A vote for the Republican is a vote for Trump's racist agenda. A vote for Janaea is a vote for justice.
Paid for by the Hamilton County Democratic Party.
Yes, my friends, it's that time of year. Election. Now, this is political season, super heavy. 1 year away from the 2020 presidential election and everything that comes with it. Are you ready? Good morning. Welcome back. I know I'm ready. 513-873-7134. If you'd like to share your thoughts, if you've got any residual election thoughts you want to share, you want to chime in on any topics that you've heard today, feel free to do so. Let's go to the phones here. Good morning. Welcome to the show. Hold on. That's all on me. Good morning. Welcome to the show. Yo, yo, can you hear me? I think we did have a caller on the line. Listen, just call me back. I'll put you back on. I believe we had a caller on the line. Call me right back. Not sure what happened. All right, let's move on. When can a podcast be made for the Kentucky counterpart of the Cincinnati metro area? Well, I mean, do you have some people who you think would be good hosts of a podcast for the Kentucky counterpart of the Cincinnati metro area? Let me know. He says, there is black folks across the river. I know. I know black people that live in Kentucky. And I know for sure that we have some listeners, black listeners, and white listeners that live in Kentucky as well. But that's a different matter than having a host who can actually pull something like that off. Let me know if you got somebody in mind. Jordan writes, what did Janaea say in the trial with Tracy Hunter? Murphy brought it up about Janaea's response seemed shaky. I don't have the details. I do know that she was involved. And I do know that she played a role in that in terms of, you know, I think she was a witness. I don't have all the details. But what I would say is, since he asked, those are good ads that make you think, what does that mean? That's a really good ad. I just think it goes to show just how important that municipal, all the judgeships, all the municipal court judges are down there important. But I think it goes to show just how important that is. Because again, that was a seat that was long time held by the Democrats, held by Fanon. Fanon leaves. The governor appoints a black Republican because they want to hold on to the seat. That's just how it goes. If the Democrats were in the vice, were in a reverse situation, they do the same thing. They do the same thing. Let me see. Clue Magic Race. I think I'm going way back now. Way back. I'm going way back. Let me try to catch up. Let me see here. Pamela Rice. So what, Drop? If Biden has the black vote, good. At least it ain't Trump. And why I keep talking about Hillary? Is she still running? Hey, good morning, Carly. Welcome to the show.
Hey, thank you. Can you hear me?
I do hear you. What's going on, G?
Oh, good, man. Good, man. I'm just on vacation and listening to the show, man, having a ball, eating breakfast, doing things I shouldn't be doing, you know. But I want to answer a couple of your questions, if I could. Sure. Earlier, you mentioned we wouldn't hear from John, and you kind of posed it as a riddle or right, some kind of question. It's election day all across the country. Am I correct?
Correct.
So he's a non-voter, big talker, but doesn't participate in the process. So he knows that he'll probably get ate up if he were to call. Am I wrong?
True. And there's another wrinkle to it. There's four states in which there's elections today. One of them is New Jersey. Oh. One of them is New Jersey. Uh-huh. So you know John ain't voting because he ain't said nothing about the New Jersey elections.
Exactly, so exactly. I never understood his logic. I've been hearing him over the years. I'm sorry.
I was just saying, I don't think he's going to call today because he knows I'm going to bring that up.
And he's exactly. Yeah, he knows how you're going to hit him in the mouth with that. He may call Lincoln, you know, somebody else or whatever, but yeah, you're absolutely right. I was listening to, Tracy and the black, and the alarm situation. That's kind of a unique situation to be in as black folk. I'm kind of leaning towards the last caller. If my son were 15, I've been in this house since 06, and my neighbors, we live in a mixed neighborhood as well. And I tell you what I would feel more comfortable if my son were interacting with another black officer. Does that make sense?
Yeah, me too. I would too.
But you know what I mean? Because he's hella less likely to be murdered by another cop that looks like him. And it's sad. I'm really kind of disgusted with police all across the board, but I would put my trust in, or not necessarily trust, maybe that's not a good word, but you know what I'm saying? I would feel more comfortable if he had an interaction with another police officer that was happened to be an African-American. As far as the political talk, the caller, a couple callers back, is whining and complaining about Biden. I don't understand why people get bogged down with the process. I'm like you, let the process play out. Who cares? I mean, whoever wins, we don't want Trump in the office, right?
Right.
So who's ever the nominee, I'm voting blue. I don't have a choice. I'm not going to get caught up in this extra third-party stuff if that person comes around, and I believe that's going to happen. I know you heard about the Tulsi Gabbard and her connections to the Kremlin and all this other stuff.
Yeah,
and it's highly likely that somebody's going to come out of the woodwork and try to disrupt the election and steal votes from the Democratic side and allow Trump in again. You know, I'm a little nervous, but if I had my choice, I would love to see Andrew Yang. Have you been following him?
I have. People say a lot of good things about him.
Yeah, I'm doing a little homework on him, and I really like what he has to offer. And I definitely, the $1,000 thing seems like a gimmick to a lot of people, but in reality, it can definitely be, it's definitely doable. Because if you reverse the tax bonanza that Trump gave to the rich people, it could easily be transferred from to the bottom. Does that make sense?
It does.
You know, as far as the trillions of dollars that the so-called fiscal conservatives have just increased the budget, the national debt, which nobody talks about. Am I wrong? Republicans always prided themselves on fiscal conservatism, right?
Until they got in office. Meaning,
until they get in office, then they spend like drunken sailors.
Yeah, they do it every time.
And nobody says a word.
And nobody says a
word. Every time.
And it becomes a landmine. It becomes a grenade or a landmine for the next president. So if we get a Democrat president, all the Republicans going to start talking about is how we can't spend and how we have a deficit. That's going to be the whole reflex and the whole stance.
We can't afford this. We can't afford that. But they just gave people who need it the least, and they're going to cut programs like Medicaid and Social Security and the affordable health care, which are all things that benefit working class people. And the saddest part to witness this whole thing is to watch these working class people, blue collar people who barely make it, or barely making ends meet, and are supporting this billionaire comment. It's really amazing to see this. But I wanted to bring up one more thing before I left you. In honor of Black Friday's coming up, right?
Yeah, sure is.
And I'm a firm believer in supporting black businesses. And I understand, I've been knowing you since the radio station, and I know that you've been out here grinding and hustling and doing what you need to do. But I wonder, do you have anything set up to where listeners like me can just contribute for the benefit of the Nathan Ivey Show, similar to like what National Public Radio does, like just straight out flat donations? I would love to be able to donate on a monthly basis to try and help you stay on the air.
Wow, I appreciate that, man. I don't take that lightly. I appreciate it, man. I mean, as a matter of fact, I do. You know, if you go to NathanIvey.com, you can see at the top of the screen, there's like several tabs. One of them reads support. And so you can either leave a one-time donation or you can become what's called a patron. And you can make a monthly donation. Uh-huh. Yep.
And a monthly donation. I mean, because you've got thousands and thousands of listeners. Even if I gave you $5-$10 a month, I'm sure if we did that on a large scale, that would propel you to be where you need to be, in my opinion, as far as competing with all of these big commercial radio stations. And I want to pledge to you $10 a month coming from me. If I'm going to call you personally because I didn't get to write that down, but I'm going to go to your Facebook page.
No, you go to my website, NathanIvey.com.
Your whip. NathanIivey.com.
Yeah, I appreciate that, man. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome, brother. You've been on the air. You're doing a service to the community. But I know, you know, you're running ads today, but people don't realize that this political season is over for today, and those ads are going to stop. Am I wrong?
Absolutely, they are. Yes.
Right. And I know that you're out here grinding and doing what you need to do and building Send Digital Media, and I'd like to help you try to grow if I could. And I want to challenge anybody else out there listening to do something similar, even if it's just $1, $5, or whatever a month, to help you compete with these big giants.
Wow.
And that's my goal. So
hey, I appreciate
that. I'll do that
man.
For you, my brother. I appreciate you.
Hey, thank you so much. I appreciate that.
You're welcome, man. Keep up the good work.
Hey, Most Def. I mean, that's G right there. I appreciate it. That's Gerald. Says he wants to make a monthly donation, and I appreciate that very much so. Well, you know, when you're doing everything, it's really about that consistency and being willing to grind, which I have no problems with. But of course, you know, when you have money behind what you're doing, then you can help build it and promote it. And again, we've been doing this for 3 years, and I've never felt more strongly about, you know, the ability of a show like this on the internet to have an impact in our community than I have right now. I've never been more convinced of it. Nobody can tell me anything different. I see it. I know it. I know the impact firsthand. I feel it on a regular basis. So again, I say this is largely because of you, you know, your support, sharing the show, getting up every morning, interacting. You know, there's people that do all kinds of stuff that you never hear about, whether it's like sending guests, shout out to my patrons, you know, who have been supporting me throughout this. And it does go a long way. It does go a long way. So I appreciate it. Appreciate it, man. What? I didn't know that was good. This is a big election day then. It's a big day. Appreciate that. All right. Let's go back to your chat here. Drop Rice Rackham, Bunky Rice Gerald Challenge, TNT Rice Support Black Business. This is a black owned endeavor. 100%. Black people are making the decisions from day one. And, you know, this was never about what anybody else wasn't doing it. It was just about adding. It was just about, hey, you know, let's add a little something. And plus, this is what I like to do. I enjoy doing this. I enjoy chopping it up every single day. When I don't do it, I miss it. Don't feel right. We've had 45 racist presidents. Stop letting the Democrats stare you into voting for more of the same. Wake up. Angela writes, Stephanie Dumas is a seat warmer, though. The Hamilton County Commissioner's race is going to be real interesting. Quite interesting. Who else is going to get into the race? We know Alicia Reese, Kelly Prather, two black females. That's going to be interesting. Angela writes, I like to see Alicia get appointed, but two niggers may be stretching it. Two? This might be a stretch, huh? Oh, man, that's hilarious. Yeah, support black business. It is a Cash App. Nathan Ivey Show is a Cash App. Yep, Nathan Ivey Show, Cash App. You put the cash symbol in Nathan Ivey Show. I appreciate it. Yeah, it does. It means a whole lot. And, you know, when I look around and I look at what's on the digital landscape, I see a lot of really good examples. And I don't see anybody doing anything that we can't do that I can't do. So and I'm talking about YouTube and things like that. So, you know, there's a lot of people who are using multiple systems. But again, if you would like to support and take the Gerald Challenge and support a black business, the Nathan Ivey Show, you can go to my website right now, NathanIveyShow.com. Click on the support tab, and you can do it two ways. One is a monthly, And shout out to all the people who either have ever been a patron. Okay, I appreciate you to the fullest. Thank you so much. And shout out to all my current patrons. I appreciate you rolling with me. It means a lot. And the thing about it, I mean, when he said that thousands of people listen to this show, he's right about that. Thousands of people will probably listen to this show today when it's all said and done. You know, when we get to the end of the week and look back at downloads and plays. And it's a multiplier effect, you know. $1 a person, $5 a person, and you multiply that, boom. Now you start to build something that you can actually create something out of. And that's what we've been doing with your support. But back to your chat. Fame writes a report, FBI intervened in Juicy Smiley host after Kamala Harris contacts appeared in phone logs. Oh, boy. D Greats from South Central, hashtag X-Squad affiliates in the house. How you doing? Squad up. Mason Muller writes, Arby's this morning. Angela writes, not amazing at all. The races like voting to keep the other races under subjugation. Right. That's not amazing at all. I mean, if you're in power and you feel like you're on top, guess what? You want to stay there. That's how the game goes. Listen, it is 10 a.m. and that's the end of the show. I got to make a hard end to today's show. And I will be out and about. I'll be talking to people at the polls. I'll be your man on the streets, just talking to people, getting their thoughts in and out of the various polling locations. I got a couple places already in mind. Perhaps I'll see you out. Make sure you get that in early today. Post your sticker. Let us know. But I'm preaching to the choir here. Most of the people in this room, in fact, I would say nearly 100% of the folks in this room are voters. Are voters. They already know. Tomorrow, we'll pick through the bones of whatever happened. The intrigue. What is going to happen with the municipal court judges? What is going to happen with the Cincinnati School Board issue 22? We'll talk about all of it and break it all down tomorrow morning, starting at 8 a.m. bright and early. Plus, you never know who we're talking to. You never know who we might be talking to or about. So make sure you check out the show. Please like and share today's show. And we'll be back tomorrow morning. Remember our motto. Very, very simple. How's it go? Respect the architect. Never test the Elohim. Wise words. Remember that. Until next time, I'm out.